total atomic annihilation, the rebuilding of this great nation of ours may fall to you. That's why we at Vault-Tec have prepared these educational materials for you to better understand the seven defining attributes that make you special. Now, let's discuss the uses of agility. A nuclear blast and the subsequent fallout will have many adverse effects on life as we know it. Intensive, prolonged radiation exposure may transform those above ground into decrepit, rotting beings that have lost their ability to reason. They will likely be without common manners and quick to anger. You must learn to make the most of available firearms, but enthusiasm will only take you so far. Now let's try that again. And remember that with your impressive agility, you can act more decisively in VATS. See? It's a snap. Agility can also help you out in difficult moments. But why place yourself under undue stress? Instead, try a subtler route. Taking the quieter approach is always worth consideration. Your agility can turn a sneak attack into a complete tactical move. Keep in mind, others may have the same bright idea. Your agility will help you move through the wasteland with ease and yield other benefits like assaulting an unsuspecting dreamer for the in hastily reloading your firearms by piling on damage to additional targets when the regularly study your Vault-Tec provided materials to prepare for survival. And to answer the question, do you know what makes you special?
My great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself. For my wife. For my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, war never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
Okay, guys. Hey, what's up? Dude Longcouch here. Welcome to Let's Play Fallout 4. Okay, we've got right stick to look around at my face. Right.
Hey, my turn, big guy.
Yeah, so we can swap out and play as a lady if we want to. I am not a lady, so I'm probably gonna stick with the dude. Since this is a role-playing game. Okay. Highlight a facial feature to sculpt using left stick. Wow, this is a pretty cool. Oh, we can change the type.
Such a
here.
Cute nose.
Roman nose. Look at all these options we have. Holy shit. Five different pugs, Hun. Five different wides.
You think my nose is too big?
We can shrink it with the bumpers too.
Oh, that's the face I fell in love with.
All right, we're gonna go with the handsome nose number two. I don't know why. Change our skin color here. I'm sure you can make some really cool stuff with this if you really wanted to get into it.
Well, hello, handsome.
I've talked about it before. I don't really get into the whole character building thing all that much. Facial hair. Huh. This is a lot of stuff to choose from. Doomsday prep, survivalist, honest Abe. Ooh, I kind of like the honest Abe. I think I'm going to go with that.
Weird. Okay. I like it.
Alright, so color always refers to skin no matter what part of the face we're on. I gotta be honest with you guys, I don't really feel like going through and doing all this. We could change the hair on top of our head too. That looks kinda awesome. Rebel. Yeah.
It's really working for me.
So how would we change our hair color? Okay, now it works on the hair. Steel gray. Kind of like the steel gray. Let's go with that. It does? The gray hair makes me look younger. I don't think you know what you're talking about, lady. Wow. Look at all the different ways we can affect this. So we can rotate it, can change the scale with the D-pad. We can move them all the way up and down. That's creepy. I'm creeped out right now. Look at that. Blah, blah. See, look, right now he's a predator. Now he's prey. Predator, prey. That's how it works. All right, our guy's definitely going to be a predator, though, so we're going to bring those eyes in, leave him set right in there.
Not bad.
Let's see. Jowls. Let's change the jowls. Bring him out a little bit. I don't have any particular plan here, I'm just doing shit. We can change our neck type. We want a fat neck or a thin neck. That's good. Right there, I guess. Strapping. This is really weird. I like how streamlined it is, how you just highlight a portion of the body and go
what
for it.
What do you think, hon? Roguishly handsome or handsomely roguish?
Got mouth top, mouth bottom. Jowls, lower temples, eyelids, forehead. Okay. I think I'm good. I don't need to make a guy who looks exactly like me or anything. Extras. Markings, blemishes, or damage. We should give our guy a scar. He should have been through some shit, I think. Middle deep. Left black deep. Forehead scar, No. Nose gouge. I kinda like that. What about a lip cut? Forced smile. Oh, that's terrible. Joker smile. Right stitches. Ooh. Some of this stuff is not very attractive. Let's go with the nose gouge. It's a scar, but it's unassuming.
You look as good as the day we met.
Blemishes. I don't think my guy has blemishes. I don't see it. Eyes gaunt. Well, that actually represents me pretty damn good. We'll give him gaunt eyes.
You say so myself.
Moles, acne, nah, I'm not feeling that. Okay, so we did the face. You know what? I just realized. If I scroll off this, is it gonna lose all the changes I just made? Choose a new character preset and discard your current changes. Nah, cancel that. I don't really feel like doing that. We'll stick with what we got. Let's look at the body type. All right, so we can jack him up, make him muscular. That's all the way thin. Or we can make him a fatty. I think we should probably put him like kind of like somewhere in the middle. Like maybe right around there. That looks pretty good. Alright guys, I think we're ready to roll. Auto saving. Alright. That was a pretty cool intro. I didn't really get to do my whole intro spiel because the game just kind of throws you into this and kind of tells you get started.
Huh?
I'm hurrying up. Don't worry.
Alright. But yeah, what I was going to say if I had a chance to start an intro was that I haven't played a ton of Fallout in my life. I did play 3, but I didn't finish it. And it's really the only Fallout game I played. Cool.
Thanks,
of course,
I want a robot like Codsworth in my apartment. Nuka-Cola. Oh man, our first choice. Do we want to drink Nuka-Cola or milk? I mean, we want cola, right?
Nuka-Cola. Ice cold.
Fuck yeah. I wonder if that affects anything. Salisbury steak.
Saddle up Salisbury steak.
Great date plus.
Sugar bombs, 100% daily value
you know,
of sugar.
I was nervous at first, but Codsworth's really good with Sean.
Yeah, my kid's crying. I'm just gonna let the robot handle him because I'm busy right now eating all the food. Salisbury steak, sugar bombs. I don't know why it gives me the option to activate it because it doesn't really do anything. Oh, look at that. Seems we have a dog. Can I drink out of the dog bowl?
Never gonna find that dog.
Alright. I guess we should go check on our kid now. Hold on. Is there any laundry to do? I'm a good husband and father. I do the chores. Or I tell the robot to do it. Radio!
Broken again.
Broken watch. That's no good.
Come on, just answer the door and he'll go away.
Answer the door. Who's at the door? You're literally standing right next to the door and you're too lazy to answer it. Jeez.
You know he's not gonna give up.
Hold on, I didn't look at my kids yet. Just, that guy can wait. Fuck him.
Enjoy your coffee, sir. Yeah. Okay.
Alright. Now that I've fulfilled my fatherly duties, I can go answer the door. Hold up.
Wonder what Sean will grow up to be.
Do you mind getting the door?
I don't know.
To think one day he's gonna learn how to drive.
Okay, let's see who this creepy looking motherfucker is.
Good morning, Vault-Tec calling.
Vault-Tec?
Vault-Tec? Remind me again.
Why, we're about you, sir. and helping secure your future. You see, Vault-Tec is the foremost builder of state-of-the-art underground fallout shelters. Vaults, if you will. Luxury accommodations where you can wait out the horrors of nuclear devastation. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
Urgency?
What's so important?
Why, nothing less than your entire future. If you haven't noticed, sir, this country has gone to heck in a handbasket. If you'll excuse my language, the big kaboom is... It's inevitable, I'm afraid, and coming sooner than you may think, if you catch my meaning. Now, I know you're a busy fellow, so I won't take up much of your time, time being a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family's service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
I'm busy, go away, sounds great. I don't know, I have no idea what this guy's talking about. This is weird. If this happened to me in real life, I would probably just be like, no, I'm good for now. So I'll say I'm busy.
I'm a little busy right now.
Oh, of course, of course. This won't take but a moment. It's just a matter of verifying some information. Need to make sure you're cleared for entrance in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation.
Sarcastic. I'm a sarcastic guy.
Now I can't wait for the world to end.
That's the spirit. Now, let's see.
Oh boy, here we go. Registration form. We've got 21 points available to put into our special statistics. Let's read each one here. Strength is a measure of your raw physical power. It affects how much you can carry and the damage of all melee attacks. Perception is your environmental awareness and sixth sense and affects weapon accuracy in VATS. I thought that was agility. Endurance is a measure of your overall physical fitness. It affects your total health and the action point drain from sprinting. Charisma is your ability to charm and convince others. It affects your success to persuade in dialogue and prices when you barter. Intelligence is a measure of your overall mental acuity and affects the number of experience points earned. Oh, okay. So the more intelligence you have, the faster you can level up. That's good to know. Agility is a measure of your overall finesse and reflexes. It affects the number of action points in VATS and your ability to sneak. Okay, so agility is not your accuracy, it's how many times you can shoot in VATS. Gotcha. Luck is a measure of your general good fortune and affects the recharge rate of critical hits. I don't know, guys. I never know how to build these out. I mean, they all seem important in one way or another. I don't know if you can max out everything eventually or if you kind of have to pick just a couple and really go for them. I think what I'll probably start out doing is probably put a bunch into strength. I like being able to carry a lot of stuff, especially in games like these. That whole encumbrance deal is a real pain in the ass. I may actually end up turning that off at some point. I have mixed feelings about that, but we'll see how the game goes. And what else do I want? Intelligence will probably be a good thing, because, like I said, we can level up faster if we have a bunch of that. And we'll say accuracy is probably one thing we want, so we'll... I'd like to put one more into perception. Let's take down... No. No, I think we're pretty good. Actually, no, let's... See, I already can't decide. This is terrible. I think it's good where it's at. We'll leave it right there. I'm good. You must name your character. Oh, shit. Where do I name my character? Okay. Gotta bring the keyboard over. This guy's name is Long Couch. Of course. Alright, we're good here.
Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments.
That was weird.
Hey, hon.
Can't believe it's almost Halloween. Sean has been changed. Need to finish making Sean's costume.
He refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that paternal affection you seem to be so good at.
You heard Codsworth. Go on.
Does that dude just fly around with his jets shooting out everywhere? How's he not set the house on fire? Also, who left the fridge open? You piece of shit robot. You're gonna fucking ruin my electric bill. I know that was me that left it open, but I'm gonna blame the robot. Because I'm an asshole. Alright, Sean. It's weird I didn't get to name my own kid.
How are the two most important men in my life doing? Spin the mobile a bit. He loves that.
Tell me what to do.
Hey, how's my little guy? Much better now, huh? Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Watch TV instead. And do what? I don't know.
What exactly?
Sir? Mom? You should come and see this!
Codsworth? What's wrong?
Followed by... yes, followed by flashes, blinding flashes, sounds of explosions. We're trying to get confirmation.
What?
We seem to have lost contact with our affiliate stations. We do have coming in. That's confirmed reports.
Codsworth.
Confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania.
Oh shit!
My God.
Sir.
Oh my God.
We need to get to the vault. Now!
I've got Sean. Let's go.
Come on, Codsworth. Shit's hitting the fan.
Of Sanctuary Hills. If you are registered.
Codsworth!
Vault 111 immediately.
I guess the robot's not coming. Man, I wanted to explore the neighborhood a little bit. If you're not in the vault program, you're fucked.
That's absurd. I am
not on the list. You don't get in.
I'm going in. You can't stop me. Okay.
Oh shit.
I'm reporting this.
If you're in the program, step forward. Otherwise, return home.
That guy got dissed. Hey, what's up?
We need to get in. We're on the list.
Infant, adult male, adult female. Okay, go ahead.
Thank you.
Good luck, ma'am.
You too.
Yay!
Come on.
What's gonna happen to all those people outside the gate?
We're doing everything we can. Now keep moving.
They're all dead. I'm a good husband, though. I got you guys in. Oh shit! I kind of want to jump in this thing. Will it let me do that? It probably won't let me do that.
This way.
I can't do shit right now.
All right, that's it. Send it down.
Almost there. We're gonna be okay. I love you, both of you.
We love you too. Oh my God!
Oh boy.
No, no. Send it down now.
Hold on.
We did it. We made it. We're okay.
Everyone, please step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
No need to worry, folks. We'll get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111. A better future underground.
So we just...
Yes, up the stairs.
I can't believe it. if we left a minute later?
No, no,
we'd all
don't get caught up thinking about that. You're safe now. Everyone, just head up these stairs and through the door there.
So I don't know much about, like, the lore of Fallout, but aren't these vaults always, like, kind of shady? Like, there's a lot more to them than what they let on?
Hey.
Up the stairs.
Or, like, they always kind of turn out horrible?
What's going on?
Up the stairs and through the door.
Excuse me.
Female and infant.
Hey.
Hello there. Once we seal the vault, we'll all be getting to know each other a lot more, I'm sure.
That guy's a pedophile. Nora, don't leave that guy alone with our kid.
Good. Over there. Take a suit. Just step over to the table.
You'll need your suits before we can take you further.
Thanks. What now?
Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
All right, you three. Follow me.
I really want to walk over the restricted area line, guys.
Sir,
this is our new home.
What? Move along.
Now just head down the hall.
What are you going to do? One of our most what are you going to do if I walk over it? What are you going to do? Great, what are you going to do, buddy? Huh? Huh? Running I'm in your face. I'm great. In your face. Check this out. Oh, I'm over the line. I'm over the line. I'm in the restricted area. Hey, buddy, what are you doing?
Excuse me.
Everything's fine. Scans are normal.
Hey there.
No need to concern yourself with these door controls. That's my job. You just relax.
Okay, creeper. I really thought that guy was gonna shoot me or something.
Welcome to Vault 111.
Each of you take one of these.
I'm sure you'll
your
feel
brand
right
new
at
vault
home.
Suits. It's down the hallway right
excuse
there.
Me.
Follow me.
I like the architecture down here.
It's gone. Our home. Everything we had.
My mother and father
keep
down
moving.
To see. Oh God, honey.
How long do you think we'll be down here?
Oh, we'll be going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through.
Just checking everyone off the list as they come in.
Prepared for the future.
A lot of these guys down here are like super calm for being in like a global apocalypse right now. I wonder if they, like, engineered the whole thing to get us down here.
I hope you'll see this as your new home.
Who are you?
Hey there.
Just follow your guide. He'll get you all
just
situated.
Just step in here and put your vault suit on.
Hey.
Step into the chamber whenever you're ready.
It'll be okay. Daddy's right here.
I don't see? Want to.
Honey.
Who's my little guy? I'm not going far. I'll just be over there.
There he is. See? Daddy's not going far.
All set? Just step
everything
inside
okay?
And put
I
on
think
your
he's
pulse.
Better. You go ahead.
All right, if you say so.
The pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault. Just relax.
So this is bullshit, right?
New life.
Resident secure. Occupant vitals normal. Procedure complete. In 5.
I do it.
3, 2, 1.
Decontaminate my nuts. I knew I was about to get frozen in here. I'm awake.
This
wow.
Is one. Here. Open it.
Yeah, that guy's a really big gun.
Almost. Everything's gonna be fine.
Come on.
Oh! You motherfucker! You just murdered my wife! By the way, I was controlling the pounding on the glass thing. Whenever I hit A, it would do that. Well, that's fucked up. So why did I wake up just to see that, and now I'm going back to sleep? Oh, man. Started out of time. Exit the vault. Okay, so there's my dead wife. She's frozen. Can I take her out?
Come on! There has to be a release!
Pressure release, right here. Do it!
Come on, come on, come on! Oh, God!
I'll find who did this. And I'll get Sean back. I promise.
Oh, man. Well, I got our wedding ring, but now I'm sad. All right. So obviously a large amount of time has passed. They want me to think that, like, my son is still alive or still a baby. And I don't know about either of those things yet.
Oh, God. Why would Vault do this?
Hello? Anyone?
They're dead.
Yeah, I was just wondering if they're all dead or not. I guess they are. So why am I the only one left alive? Well, they said, I guess because they said I'm a backup for whatever their nefarious plot is. So that's why they didn't want to kill me. Something about our genetics, I guess. Me and my son. Alright, before I go, we gotta explore this place. Guys, if you don't know anything about Fallout, there's gonna be a lot of wall crawling, a lot of collecting stuff. Welcome to Robco Industries Termlink, Vault 111 Security Instructions, Operations Protocol Manual. Load holotape. I have no idea what I'm doing here. Let's dive in. Vault 111 is designed to test the long-term effects of suspended animation on unaware human subjects. You bastards. Security staff are responsible for maintaining installation integrity and monitoring science staff activity. Under no circumstances are staff allowed to deviate from assigned duties. Insubordination or interference with vault operations are capital offenses. Security staff are authorized to use lethal force. Alright. Resident admittance. There's a lot to go through here. Upon activation notice from Vault Tech, all personnel are required to report to the entry area and assist with admittance of vault residents. Security personnel will maintain order and ensure that no personnel or residents attempt to evacuate the vault. Research staff will be responsible for resident intake and escort each to the designated cryogenic pod. Residents not accounted for in the manifest should be asked to step aside and detained forcefully by security if necessary. Once all residents have been sealed into their preservation chambers, dispose of any detainees. Vault entryway must remain sealed under any circumstances. So it's just kind of repeating a lot of the- oh my god, it drills down even deeper. Alright, there's kind of too much here for me to really read all of it out loud to you. I'm gonna scan it. I don't think it's really adding a lot to the actual story, it's just, you know, giving context for the world. If you guys want to read through the whole thing, feel free to go ahead and pause the video. Yeah, so this is basically like a little fascist society I got myself into. This might be interesting. Following a nuclear event, Vault-Tec will monitor hazards such as radiation levels, enemy invasions, subsequent attacks, and other factors. Once conditions are deemed safe, this terminal will receive an all-clear notice. Upon receiving it, Vault-Tec personnel may be evacuated at overseer discretion. Disregard any notices from organizations or individuals not associated with Vault-Tec, including government and military. Residents are not to be disrupted or evacuated. Vault-Tec will attend to their needs remotely. Okay. Vault 111 is classified as a short-term assignment. Non-resident personnel are expected to carry out research duties and basic maintenance of the vault. The absence of an all-clear message from Vault-Tec, the overseer may elect to evacuate staff after a mandatory shelter period of 180 days. Under no circumstances may Vault staff evacuate during the shelter period. Okay. I have a feeling it was a lot longer than that. And security logs. Oh my god. So the year was 2077, right? God, it finally happened. The world's over. Barely got all the residents inside. Not everyone made it. Now it's just us and the icebergs. I don't get it. Egghead tried to explain to me that keeping them frozen is a big experiment. For a better future or something. I don't know. It just doesn't seem right that we were smiling at them all that time before putting them on ice. Shouldn't we have told them something? Yeah, probably. Shitbag. Christmas Underground. Got together with the rest of the security boys and support staff and had a little party. Best gift that got handed out was a fancy lad snack cake that wasn't too stale. None of the scientists came. Overseer wasn't there either. I just don't get them. They hiding something from us? Another company secret only for the higher-ups? Whatever. Just a few more months until the all-clear is supposed to come through. Then we can start rebuilding. Uh-huh. Alright, so here's a few months later. Only a few weeks left in our mandatory shelter period. Everyone's getting stir-crazy. Some people are even saying the all-clear signal is never coming. We can't stay here much longer, that's for sure. It's not just the fact that I've been staring at the same break room and bunk bed for over 6 months. It's the fact that we only have enough food left for another few months. Tops. The overseer kept telling everyone to be patient, focus on work. He's definitely keeping us out of the loop. Something bad is going on. I just know it. And about a month after that, the main door accessing the vault exit is malfunctioning. Now the only way out is through the overseer's evacuation tunnel. How convenient for him. He has one of the science team watching the door into his office at all times from a little makeshift checkpoint. Got invited to a meeting tonight. Support staffers and security only. Sounds like I'm not the only one with an axe to grind. And the last entry. No all clear from Vault-Tec is coming. We need to leave. We're all but out of food. I almost murdered Stanley for dropping a damn salt cracker on the floor. A handful of us confronted the overseer about opening up the vault. I never knew a man that small could shout that loud. Now he's locked himself in his office along with the rest of the science staff. We're supposed to hand over any food, weapons, and medicine we have by tonight, or there's going to be consequences. I've talked to everyone. It's time. One way or another, we're getting out of this vault. And that's the last info we've got here. Jeez. So, I'm trying to think back to Fallout 3. I played that game, like, right when it first came out. Ooh. Take a stim pack. And, why do I have two wedding rings? That's weird. Alright, well, I don't want to store anything in there. Was Vault 111 the same vault you were in Fallout 3? Is this the same place? Because I want to say there was a guy named Stanley in the intro to that game, too, but I could be mistaken. I'm actually going to have to look that up. Ooh, got a security baton. Awesome. Haha! Press D-pad to view your available favorited items. Right now, all I have is the baton and the stim pack. Alright. So what was the way out of here? Not this way. I want to make sure I explore this whole place before I do that. I thought I could go through that door right there, but I can't. Alright, we cannot go back this way, right? No. Wait. Nope, I thought that might be a storage box. Okay, let's try this door. Negative. Some more cryopods. Alright, I guess this is actually the only way we can go. This intro video is going to be pretty long, guys. I always like to do a longer intro video. Just because a lot of them tend to be, like, drawn out. And, you know, I don't want to break it up. Subsequent videos will be much shorter. Probably, you know, the average 20, 25, 30 minutes. But for right now, we're gonna keep going, see if we can't get out of this vault before we, close out this opening part. And I really have no idea what I'm doing as far as controls and whatnot. Okay, RT to attack. Ugh! Stupid rad roach.
giant roaches? What the hell?
So if I hit X to transfer, I could store things on the rad roach. I don't want to do that. There's more in there. Alright, hold up. Recreational terminal. Alright, we got some more things on here. Overseer memo. Remember, use of the recreational terminal is a privilege. If work performance declines, this privilege may be revoked. Alright. Rick, Tim, TGM. I don't know what the hell this is. It's like a high score arcade cabinet or something. And we got a tape to play. Oh shit, look at this. It's a Donkey Kong clone. How high can you get? Alright. I'm the little Fallout boy thing. Guy. Alright. Oh shit. Huh. Whoop. Huh. Made it. Alright, that was 25, here's 50. This really does feel like an old, crappy game. Ugh. Oh shit. Trying to control it with the D-pad is somewhat difficult. Get up there. Yeah. Alright, 75 meters, here we go. Oh, this is the deal where we gotta drop all these, don't we? Alright. Ah, fuck you. What is that thing? Is that like an extra life? Oh, I'm fucked. Oh, I made mistakes. No! Really? I didn't think he was that close to me. Oh, but I got 3 lives. Okay. Those floating head things, I can't really tell what they're supposed to be. No. Shit. They're camping that area. Okay, this is impossible. They won't leave. Fuck. I'm fucked. Oh, no, no, okay. Wow, this is really difficult. Alright, last try, here we go. Let's do all 3 on this side first. Don't climb back. Fuck you! I'm hitting right, I swear to God. This might have been a mistake. Oh yeah, yeah, they're staying on that side. Awesome. Down, 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 down. Yeah! I win! There's a... Oh, it's just repeating now. Okay. I don't really need to keep going with that. That was cool. Eject the holotape. Does that mean I can take it with me? Yes! I stole their video game. That makes me so happy. That was cool. I like the tune that was playing during that. The little dun 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 dun. I hope I can, like, listen to it at some point. Like, you know, on, like, a tape player or something. Or my Pip-Boy. Cleanliness is godliness. That's what they say. Alright, let's get my beater stick ready. What is this? This is the one I already beat up. Just looking for things to loot right now. I know that the way forward is that way. All right, I think we're good on this side. Oh shit! I'm gonna go ahead and not walk through that thing. Oh, I can block. Oh, that's cool. What's that? Little bastard. I didn't see that guy coming. Trying to take that sweet, sweet rad roach meat. Take it all. By the way, do I even have my jumpsuit equipped right now? Like, am I supposed to? I don't even know. Oh, that guy's dead as shit.
What happened here? Where is everyone?
I hope there's no, like, secret weapon or anything hidden in that area, because I'm not walking in there. Right bumper to power attack. Nice. It's a slow but powerful swing, it seems. Just refill my HP? Nice. I like it. I was curious if that would come back automatically over time, or if I always have to take something to replenish it. Right now I'm just gonna take everything I find, because I don't know what's useful and what's not. But until I run out of room, I'm gonna loot everything.
Is this all that's left?
Oh, hell yeah. Now we're talking. Stimpaks restore 30% of your max health, heal damaged limbs, and can be favored for quick use. Alright. So I can zoom, I can aim down the sights with left trigger. I'm guessing that right trigger is fire, but I'm not gonna test it yet. What is this? Cryolator case.
Nice. Coming back later for you.
Damn! So that's called a lock tease right there. When a game shows you something behind something that you can't access yet because you don't have the skill or whatever, but you know you can come back later and get it. It's called a lock tease. Penny Arcade coined that term. It's a great term. Alright. I know that Vats is in this game. I don't know how to activate it yet. I'll take some cigarettes. I don't plan on smoking myself, but I can probably sell them. Wait, what was that? What do I keep seeing? Oh, the sliding door. Okay. Got a fair amount of ammo, so I like that. I don't know if each drawer is separate or if it's just one giant thing. Well, it looks like there's nothing in there. Almost missed this. Can I crouch, by the way? I don't seem to be able to jump or crouch right now. Oh, here we go. If I click the right stick, I can crouch. Okay. Click the left stick, I can run. Alright, I think I got it.
Terminal somewhere.
Damn it. Okay, we gotta find the terminal to unlock the door. It's probably somewhere close, right? Did I miss it back here? No. Oh. Overseer's terminal. Okay. Oh boy, that is a lot of stuff. Alright, let's start with the Overseer instructions. Vault 111 is designed to test the long-term effects of suspended animation. Oh, we already read this. Alright. Let's read about the cryolator. I've long dreamed of making cryogenic freezing available in a portable, on-demand form. The cryolator is my latest attempt. Thankfully, we're in no short supply of the chemicals and components I need to tinker with the prototype. It's a nice way to occupy the time as we wait for the all-clear signal. So that's like a freeze ray. I could be Mr. Freeze if I got it. Did I already read? Yeah, I think I read all those already. Or at least scanned them. The Overseer's Log. Oh boy, this is new stuff. Alright, again, I'm gonna scan them myself. If you guys want to read them to completion, go ahead and just pause the video. Alright. Okay. So they have problems with the cryo tanks. Oh, there's more to it. How do I see the rest? Okay. Got it. Alright, so he knew the mutiny was coming. Wasn't much he could do about it, though. Personnel evacuation tunnel is now open. Remind all staff to be orderly. Okay, good. We should be able to get out of here now. I don't know why I would never have my gun equipped. Like, I don't know if I can put it away when I want to. I can melee with left bumper. Or, sorry, right bumper melees. Left bumper makes that little clicky sound. Oh, that's how we go into vats. Okay. Interesting. It doesn't completely stop time. It just slows it down. Alright, so I do that. Right trigger to mark the parts I want to shoot. And then A to accept. Good stuff. I haven't really figured out... you little bastard. Like, how much I'm gonna rely on vats and how much I'm gonna rely on, like, actual shooting. I'm more of an action gamer and less of an RPG gamer. So I kinda like actually aiming. Assuming I'm actually good enough to do it. But it all depends on how the game is designed, you know. You little fucker. It's probably not always going to be easy to get those shots off. Nope. Okay. It's really weird that they let you transfer stuff to these rad roach corpses. Okay. Crouch down and sneak. Move slowly, avoid bright light, use melee attacks to remain undetected. Okay. Cool. I'm gonna punch him in his butt. Oh yeah. Sneak attack for 2x damage. I like it. I've gotta stop hitting X to do that. I keep thinking the X is gonna be like a take all button, but that's totally not what it is. I hope that there is something like that eventually. Alright, what the hell is all this? What? Cool. Oh, a Pip-Boy! Man, that's sweet. Okay. 64 kilobytes of RAM. Awesome. Alright, so here we go. This is kind of like our little data companion device. Change tabs with LT and RT. Change sections with the D-pad. Well, let's see what we got. Here's our inventory. This is our stats screen. Which we can see... Special perks and status. Alright. We've got a data screen. I guess this shows quests, workshops, whatever workshops are, I don't know yet, and general stats for gameplay. We can see a map of what's going on, and of course we've got the radio tuner. I don't seem to be able to manipulate this just yet. Alright. So there you go. Actually, let me pull up this. So I can do a quick save. I can save, load, get help, and there's settings in there. That's good to know. One drawback of playing with a controller instead of a keyboard is not having like the hotkeys for quick save and quick load. But I think we'll probably be okay. Nothing down here.
Is anyone alive?
I think not, sir.
Get out? Oh god.
All right, so we've got a bunch of stuff in our inventory. Ooh. I'll take some tools. We've got a gun. We've got a melee weapon. We've got our Pip-Boy. I would assume we're going to be done in here soon. I've officially gotten turned around. Is that the one I was playing on before? Whoa. Wow, you can't really steer very well when you're sprinting like that. Okay. Vault door remote access ready.
Vault door cycling sequence initiated. Please stand back.
I'm ready for whatever's out there. Let's do this. This is taking forever. Ah, it's bright. That was a lot of hoo-ha and fanfare. Do you want to change anything? Change name or special attributes? Nah, I'm pretty cool with what I picked so far.
Enjoy your return to the surface, and thank you for choosing Vault Tech.
You're welcome. Ooh, that guy's nasty looking. Look at that. Commonwealth is a dangerous place, but tends to get considerably more dangerous the farther south you travel. Alright. Oh look, I can manipulate him while the screen's loading. That's pretty cool. Oh man, this is that moment, guys. That moment in every Bethesda title, when you complete the intro, you step outside, and there's just... feels like unlimited space around you. You can just pick a direction and run, and you have no idea what you're gonna run into. This is like the best moment in like every Bethesda game. Just the unbridled potential. I love it. Alright! Well, that's my intro video for Fallout 4, guys. Thank you very much for watching. If you made it this far, I know it's long. But, it had to be done. We had to get through it. Yeah, take a look in here real quick. Nuka-Cola bottles. I don't know why I want empty bottles. Ooh, I want Rataway. Give me that. There's an elevator button. A folder. I'm taking everything. I am the hoarder. That's what they call me. But anyway, guys, yeah. I'm gonna go ahead and, give you blue balls here, because this is where I gotta call it. When we come back, guys... we're just going to pick a direction and run and see what we find. I'm pretty excited about this game. I didn't complete Fallout 3, but I did love it, what I played of it. I didn't finish it, not because I didn't like it, just because I fell away from it. Because I tend to do that with a lot of games. I'm a weirdo. But I'm going to see this one through. I'm going to do it for you guys. I'm glad that we can experience this together. So thanks for watching, guys. I'm Dude Long Couch. This is Fallout 4, and I will catch you guys in part 2. See ya.